early in the morning or late in the evening. But I don't encourage you guys to go looking for moose in the nighttime. That's not a good thing to do, because there are a lot of moose here. The moose were brought in from the front. The caribou all migrate up into the mountains in the summertime. They got up high in the high country. They disappear from the highway. In the springtime, when people come here, there's 200 or 300 moose or caribou hanging around out by the airport all spring long. They've all migrated up high then. So the caribou are native to Newfoundland. The moose are not native to Newfoundland. Wednesday we have an annual moose hunt. Myself and the captain, we both have a moose license for this year. I paid $59 for my moose license. Cooper got his for $35. Why is that? Because he's old, right? He keeps telling me he's a preferred customer. It's got nothing to do with being a preferred customer. It's got everything to do with called a senior's discount. And that's what he gets. It's a pool system, so it's a lottery. Yeah, so they give out 35,000 licenses on the island every year. And I have a moose license this year. Captain has one as well, yeah. No, I have one every year that I've ever applied. Skipper gets one every second year. His wife gets one every other year. So he has one every year as well. Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, and the same thing in Ontario. So, yeah. Corporate guillemots in the cold, yeah, those are the black guillemots. We saw a few of those earlier, yeah. This is one of my favorite areas to come on tour. This is, like I said, Familiar Bay. The cliffs extend up about 250 to 300 feet above sea level. And a lot of people get really nervous when they come along by the rocks like this, but there's about 60 feet of water, 70 feet of water where we're at right now. And we're going to pass by this sea cave on the left-hand side so everybody can have a look. Now, back in the mid-50s, there was a man by the name of Billy Earl that spent 6 days and six nights inside the sea cave. And for the first time this year, first time in 5 years, somebody said, why? Well, back in the mid-50s, there was no boat, no roads, no phones. So this gentleman left St. Mary Bridget, which is about 10 to 15 miles to the south and north of where we are. Lodamine Brook, which is right at the bottom of that bay where we were watching the whales. We're up in the bottom of Hare Bay. And when he got here by the oven, there was a lot of bird activity. So he came over to check it out, figured there may be some capel running in the back of the cave. So he came in to have a look, and when he did, his boat struck the rocks and punctured a large gaping hole in his boat. The boat sunk to the bottom. And he pulled himself up on the rock ledge. You see him about halfway back in the shadow. This big rock ledge on the back, on the right-hand side. He spent 6 days and six nights there. And so somebody came by one day, because like I said, his wife thought he was down to Main Brook. People in Main Brook thought he was in St. Lanier. Nobody really knew where he was. One day they heard somebody came.